problem of assignment and transportation. So now we'll solve some more problem of assignment and transportation from this. Alright, one problem from EAC 2010. So what is the problem? EAC 2010, very simple. We consider the following statements. First statement, for the application of optimality test, optimality test in case of transportation model, the number of allocations should be equal to m plus n. Second, transportation problem is a special case of linear programming problem. Transportation problem is a special case of LPP. Third, in case of assignment problem, the first step is to make a square matrix. By adding a dummy row or dummy column. So which of the statements are correct? Just write the options. First option, 1, 2 and 3. All three are correct. Second, 1 and 2 only. Third, 2 and 3. And fourth, 2 only. Right, now just look at here. How we can say how many statements are correct here. So we will go first statement by statement. So just look at here. So the application of optimality test in the case of transportation, the number of allocations should be equal to m plus n. Right. So I think this is not correct here, because I have discussed with you that number of allocations will be, we have only two options. Either it can be equal to m plus n minus 1, or it should be less than m plus n minus 1. It can't be more than, never it should be greater than m plus, greater than m plus n minus 1. It should not be greater than m plus n minus 1. What is the reason behind it? Because how many number of equations we have? M plus n minus 1. And since we know number of basic variables cannot be more than number of equations. Already we know, suppose we have 9 variables and 5 equations here. So what I can do here, to get the solution out of 9 variables, four variables need to be put at zero here. So four variables will be put to zero here. So then rest five can be calculated here from the school level mathematics here. So from the school level mathematics, what I can say here, out of nine variables, if only we have five equations here, so first four variables, any four variable will be put to zero, so that rest five variable can be calculated here. So I can say here the number of non-zero variables will be equal to only five here, because the four variables will be equal to zero here, and non-zero variables are also known as allocation or basic variables here. So what we can say here, number of allocations cannot be more than m plus n minus 1, never greater than m plus n minus 1. So how the number of allocations can be equal to m plus n? Because this value is greater than m plus n minus 1. So this is not possible case here. So this is the wrong statement here. This is the wrong statement, because I have only two possibilities only. Right, not the third one. Now just look at here, second statement, transportation problem is a special case of LPP. So many times in the class I have told you that transportation problem is a special case of LPP. And from where I have started the transportation problem? I have started the transportation problem or the formulation of transportation problem just like LPP only here, right? So it is a it is a special case of LPP here, right? Now next, in case of assignment problem, the first step is to make a square matrix by adding a dummy row or dummy column. Right, definitely this is also correct here, because right now I have discussed with you right before the break that if we have a problem which is both, that is which is unbalanced also and which is of maximization also, so don't go for first maximization to minimization. First go for balancing it, then go for maximization to minimization, otherwise you will be wrong here. So definitely this is also a correct statement. So 2 and 3 are correct here, but first one is wrong here. So option C will be correct here. So in this way we can decide here. Right, now we'll solve one or two more problem, right, like this only. How we can able to solve? So these questions are very simple, no calculation is required here, but logically we can able to decide, or with the help of very good fundamental concepts we can able to decide which options will be correct here. So whenever we have a very small problem of 1 marks in GATE or engineering service examination, so this will be like this only, so that we can by our logic, if we have a good concept, we can able to solve it very easily here. In a transportation problem from EAC 2011, in a transportation problem, how is an unacceptable transportation route handled? Unacceptable transportation route handled. Where are the options? First option, by giving it a cost of zero. Second options, by carrying an extremely high cost. Third, by introducing a dummy destination. A dummy destination. And the last one is by introducing a dummy origin. Now just look at here, how we can able to solve this problem here. So what is the meaning of unacceptable? So how in a transportation problem, how an unacceptable transportation route is handled here? The same case, if it is a case of fully satisfied, fully satisfied case, fully satisfied case. What happened in case of fully satisfied case here? Just look at here. If this one is the condition here, if we have suppose S1, suppose we have S2, and suppose we have SD here, and here we have suppose D1, here we have suppose D2, and here we have D3 here, and suppose it required 250 units. And suppose if D1 has to be fully satisfied, if D1 has to be fully satisfied, so how what I have discussed with you, if D1 has to be fully satisfied, there will be no supply, there will be no supply from the dummy to D1 here. All the supply will be from S1 and S2. No supply from dummy, that is the virtual, that is the imaginary. There will be no supply from the imaginary to the D1, because D1 has to be fully satisfied. So what I have discussed with you, don't assume the value of Xij by our own. We can't able to assume the value of Xij, but we can assume the value of Cij. So I have put it M here. What is the meaning of M? M means infinity. That means a very high positive value, that is known as M or infinity here. So here what I can say here, so this is a condition is known as unacceptable. That means D1 can't accept supply from SD here. This is known as unacceptable condition here. So in case of unacceptable condition, I have just discussed with you in very detail that it should be M here. So Cij should be equal to M here. That is very large positive value here. So here also it is given by giving a cost zero. No, not correct here. By carrying an extremely high cost, definitely by carrying an extremely high cost here. And by introducing a dummy row or dummy column, no. Because here already will balance it now. So how it will be handled here? So definitely to handle here, Cij will be equal to M here. If Cij will be equal to M here, so definitely I can say second option is the right option here. So in this way, right, this type of problem can be handled here. Suppose a student know the concepts well. So how much time he will take to solve the problem? Not more than 20 seconds, right? In 20 seconds I am including both the things, the time to read the problem also, right? And suppose if I exclude the time, suppose if you after reading the problem, how much time it will take? After reading the problem, it will take only 2 seconds, not more than 2 seconds, if concept is very good, right? Right, one from 2007. Consider the following statement. Consider following statements. The assignment problem is seen to be the assignment problem is seen to be the special case of transportation problem. In which statement number 1, M is equal to N. Statement number 2, All AI should be equal to 1. And the question, third statement, Xij should be equal to 1. So which are the correct statements? The first 1, 2, 3, all. Second, only 1 and 2. Third, only 2 and 3. Last, 1 and 3. Okay, now just look at here. Now just look at here. So what will happen? So what will happen here? Assignment problem is a special case of transportation problem, and I think I have discussed with you in the class very detail. Right, what happened here? So definitely it's a square matrix. So suppose transportation problem is of m cross n here. So definitely what will happen to assignment problem? A square matrix, that is n cross n. That means m will become equal to n here. So that is the right statement here. Second, all ai should be equal to 1. Yeah, definitely. Already I have stated you that in case of transportation, this value can be 200, 300, 500, like this only. But in case of assignment, this value should be 1, 1, 1. All the AI and BJ, all the AI as well as BJ should be equal to only 1, should be equal to 1. Definitely, this is also correct here. But third one is not correct. Why third one is not correct? Because here it is saying that the decision variable xij, the decision variable xij should be equal to 1. No, it should be either 1 or it should be 0 also. Either it should be 1 or it should be 0, but not exactly. But suppose if we put some summation, that summation of xij, from i is equal to 1 to m, like this only, then it can be correct here. Why it can be correct here? By summation of all xij, right, it will be 1. Summation of all xij, it will be 1. Summation of all xij, 1 here, like this only. So if there will be summation sign, then it will be correct here. But if only we have xij, that is what should be the value of decision variables. So the value of decision variables should be either 0 or 1, but not only 1 here. So third is not the correct statement here. Only first and second here. So option B will be correct. Only first and second statement is correct here. Okay, so here we have completed this transportation assignment problem here, and now I will start a new topic, right?